Hello friends, my name is Vibha Sharma and today we deal with the chapter Why Do We Fall Ill? First of all, I would like to tell you what is the human health and disease. So every living organism, maybe it is a plant or animal, requires nutrition, or we can say food, for its survival, maintenance, growth and development. So the proper diet habits leads to good health and proper mental development. But how can we say that the person is healthy or not? So we can say that if a person has no symptom of disease, symptoms are the first evidence of disease, which are shown morphologically. These are the symptoms were shown morphologically as well as internally, but we can say in the external appearance, so that the first sign of, or we can say that the first evidence of having disease. So whenever a person is said to be healthy, if one has no symptom of disease, has no physical deformity, and it leads a purposeful life, as well as all the body organs function very properly and has sufficient diet. So these are the basic points through which we can say that the person is healthy or not. But what is the definition of health? So according to World Health Organization, that is WHO, it is the most widely accepted definition in 1947, when WHO description states that health is a state of physical, mental and social well-being. Physical, mental and social well-being means it's a state of a physical, mentally as well as socially well, and being not merely the absence or of disease or infirmity. It's not, we can say that. So it's a most widely accepted definition of health by the WHO, that it's a state of physical, mental and socially well-being with the society. So, and what is the significance of health? Significance is a good health is Good health is healthy body with a healthy mind and healthy attitude. Healthy body with a healthy mind and healthy attitude. And good health increases our efficiency for doing work as well as, and it will lead to the progress of its own, and it finally leads to the progress of the community and then the progress of nation as a whole. So we can say that good health is a condition for our purposeful existence in this world. And now we talk about what is a disease. A disease is a condition of the body or a part of it in which functions are disturbed. Disease, it consists of two words, dis and ease, means comfort. Means when there is kind of discomfort in the body, we can say that we can suffer from a disease. Discomfort. That is, in short, we can say that disease is a disorder of body. Is a disorder of body. Disease can also be defined as the morphological, that is the structural, physiological, that is functional or psychological disturbance in the body or body parts, which caused by the external agencies, maybe non-parasitic. For example, if there is a kind of deficiency disease which is due to the nutrients, or it may be a parasitic which is caused by due to the virus, bacteria and fungi. So all these are the different factors which are responsible for having disease. And what are the distinction between the health and the disease free? What is the difference between health and disease free? So health, healthy and disease free. Health is basically a state of physical, mental and social well, while disease free is a state of absence of any discomfort. healthy, whenever we can say that a person is said to be healthy, then it can be in the state of physical, mental and socially well. State of mental, physical and socially well. While disease free is a state of absence of any kind of discomfort, absence of body discomfort. And a person can be unhealthy even in the absence of disease, while a person would be disease free in the absence of discomfort. That is the another difference. A person can be healthy even in the absence of disease, while disease free in the absence of discomfort. And another difference between healthy and disease free is, it depends in healthy, in case of healthy person, it depends only upon the person as well as the environment which is including society around us. And while in disease free, depend upon the person alone. And there are various terms related to diseases that are the terms related to diseases. First is incubation period. Incubation period. It's a interval or it's a period which is present between infection and the appearance of first symptom of the disease. That is period between infection. And what is infection? Infection is whenever there is an entry of pathogen in the body, it is called as infection. So, and pathogen are the disease causing organism like bacteria, virus and fungi. So whenever there is a first infection between the appearance, it's a period between the infection and appearance of first symptom. Appearance of first symptom, which is called as incubation period. Second term is antibiotic. Antibiotic is what? Antibiotic are those chemicals that kill or stop the growth of certain kind of microbes which enter in our body. So whenever we have a disease, then we can take antibiotics, which is helpful in the destruction of the pathogens or the microbes. But basically antibiotic destroys the bacterial diseases. So these are the chemical which kill or stop the growth of microbes. Third term is vaccine. And vaccine is what? It is a suspension. It's a suspension of disease producing microorganisms which is modified by killing or weakening, so that the suspension will not cause any disease. Whenever we inject vaccine in someone's body, and that is responsible for the destruction of the microorganisms. Basically, it was formed by the microorganism, but it is formed by the inactive or weakening or inactive or killing by the inactive or killing the microorganisms. So it's a suspension of killed or inactive, which is in a state of attenuated microbe. Now there is another term, that is antibodies. Antibodies, these are also the special chemicals which are found in the blood against the attack of germs or their secretion. So whenever any pathogen like bacteria, virus attacks in our body, we have a immune system which are responsible for the production of these antibodies, and they are helpful in the destruction of that microbes. So these are the chemical found in blood, and these are secreted by our immune system, different cells of our immune systems found in blood, act against . Next term is antigen. Antigen, these are the proteins or other harmful chemicals that are present on the surface of invaders. Invaders which invades our body whenever there is an infection, that the germs or pathogen, these are also known as the invaders, which invades our body, and these are the antigen. These are the proteins or harmful chemicals which are present on surface of invaders. So this is basically introduction for what is health, what is disease, and the various terms regarding diseases. In next session we talk about what is the manifestation of diseases and what are acute and chronic diseases and different types of diseases which are caused by bacteria and virus, fungi and protozoans and all. Thank you.